In part 4 of our lesson on powers and roots of complex numbers, you will learn how to solve an equation using the nth root theorem. In this example, we have to solve x cubed minus 64i is equal to 0. The instructions say to use radian angles in your trig form, then put your final answers in rectangular form. So let's start by writing down our equation. We have x cubed minus 64i is equal to 0, which means x cubed is equal to 64i, which means that x is equal to the cube root of 64i. So what these instructions then are asking us to do, by asking us to solve this equation, they're really asking us to find the three cube roots of z equals 64i. So as we've done in the other examples, the first order of business will be to draw z and put it into trig form. Since z is equal to 64i, we know that another way of saying that is that z is equal to 0 plus 64i, which means the x value is 0 and the y value is 64. So here is our z. This is one of those easy ones where we can see right away that r is equal to 64. And of course, we can always calculate it if we need to. R would be the square root of x squared plus y squared, which is the square root of 0 squared plus 64 squared, which is obviously 64. Theta, very easy to see. We have to be in radian angles in this problem, so theta will be pi over 2. So in trig form, 0 is equal to 64 cis pi over 2. Step 2 is to find the formula for the alpha k's. We know the rule says that alpha k has to be the nth root of r cis theta plus 2k pi over n, because we are in radians. In our case, we are finding the three cube roots, so that means n is going to equal 3. From the trig form of z, we see that r is equal to 64, and theta is equal to pi over 2. So as we plug in, we're going to get alpha k is equal to the cube root of 64 cis pi over 2 plus 2k pi divided by 3. Simplifying, we know that the cube root of 64 is 4 cis. We have a complex fraction here. We can simplify this by multiplying by 1 in the form of 2 over 2. So the argument becomes pi plus 4k pi over 6. And this is going to be our alpha k, and we know that we will plug in k is equal to 0, 1, and 2. Since n is equal to 3, we have to stop at n minus 1, which is 2. Now that we have our formula for alpha k, the third step is to use that formula to calculate the alpha k's. Alpha 0 is going to equal 4 cis pi plus 4 times 0 times pi over 6, which becomes 4 cis pi over 6, which becomes 4 times the quantity. Once again, let's do this in our heads. The cosine of pi over 6 is radical 3 over 2 plus I times the sine of pi over 6 is 1/2. Distributing the 4, we get 2 radical 3 plus 2i, and that is alpha 0. Alpha 1 will be 4 cis pi plus 4 times 1 times pi over 6, which is equal to 4 cis 5 pi over 6, which is equal to 4 times the quantity. Cosine of 5 pi over 6 is negative radical 3 over 2 plus I times the sine of 5 pi over 6, which is positive 1/2. Distributing that 4, we get negative 2 radical 3 plus 2i, and that is alpha 1. Alpha 2 will equal 4 cis pi plus 4 times 2 times pi over 6. Now in this argument, we see we have 8 pi plus pi. That would be 9 pi over 6, which of course reduces to 3 pi over 2. So this becomes 4 cis 3 pi over 2, we take 4 times the cosine of 3 pi over 2, 0, plus I times the sine of 3 pi over 2, negative 1. So this is 0 minus 4i, and that is alpha 2. Or you could write this one as just negative 4i. Either way of writing this is equally good. And these are the three cube roots which would solve that original equation of x cubed minus 64i is equal to 0.